Most interventions have the starting point of, can we show that anything that we think is in the kind of broad category of things that would be of value have changed as a result of doing this? And oftentimes, the conclusion can be, if you measure a number of different things, that something will have changed. But just focusing on whether something has changed really does not help us understand what the mechanisms are of change. I think what's unique about this approach is a really strong emphasis on stating upfront what you think is going to be impacted directly by what you're doing, and how that might be related to then downstream kinds of things that would be desirable goals for your program to impact in the long run.
Our approach to evaluation involves the use of core and recommended measures to investigate a clear and precise theory of change. Using these core and recommended measures that are similar across projects, it allows us to compare apples to apples, if you will. So if we have a number of projects that are focused on maternal depression, we have the capacity then for those different projects to share their learnings in more accessible terms because they approached their evaluation using similar measures. Whereas what often happens in the field is that you may have 10 different studies of maternal depression and they used 10 different measures to look at that symptomology and that change over time, which makes it very difficult to sort of have cross-learning and to compare the outcomes of those different studies. What we've learned is that we really need to partner closely with sites to understand sort of what their capacity for gathering data is, to work with them to build that capacity, and to do everything we can to build an evaluation plan that's really doable in their context.
For very early stage programs, where the program's never been tried out before with anybody, the evaluation process is often simply about feasibility. As the program develops further, there's really an emphasis on increasing the amount of information that we're collecting. And often we'll shift from more of just basic feasibility and qualitative kinds of questions to more quantitative ones, where we're collecting data. The evaluation plan, therefore, is something that kind of evolves. It's like a living document that changes with successive cycles in the iteration process. But eventually, the goal is to get to a place where we're able very clearly and precisely to measure all of the aspects of the program's theory of change.